Talofalava, Deputy Prime Minister and Acting Prime Minister, thank you so much for this opportunity to be here with you. It's been a week since a historic and really special occasion where you received your malu. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good. Still a lot of bruising and still just have to be a little bit careful getting around and haven't gone out as much as what I otherwise would have. But absolutely loving looking down at my markings and my legs, and as I've said previously, it almost feels like it's always been here now.
And can you talk us through the journey to making that decision to get the malu?
Much of it for me was instinctive, and so as I was going through my teens and others were getting tattoos, I instinctively knew that that wasn't for me. And then when I came to Auckland at 18 and then first saw the malu, and then over the years learnt more about it, I realised that was what I wanted. It was just a matter of timing, and really the timing couldn't have been better.
Just how special was it to have your dad there? You were surrounded by family and friends. Did your dad have any advice for you?
No, first time he'd seen it done, actually. He came over from Samoa when he was 20, and so hadn't been immersed in the Samoan community either, because he decided to settle in Taranaki with his family. And so he watched on the whole day with intense interest in what was happening. It was the first time I'd seen it.
For many of us here, Pasifika, in New Zealand, Australia, abroad, having that connection with the tattoo, was that something that was on your mind during that whole process, that having that connection?
Yeah, absolutely. And it's the connection not just to the tattoo, it's the connection to everything to do with our ainga, our culture, our homeland of Samoa. And so when you are going through the motions, you are taking yourself to another place. And for me, it was reflections of those relationships, of those people, of the smells, of the memories and the places I've been there. And so all of that was what kept me in a zone, I guess, to be able to more easily handle what was happening with the actual process of getting the malu.
Do you feel a different type of pressure now that you have the malu? You're the Deputy Prime Minister. Your profile is huge. Do you feel that sense of pressure?
I guess the pressure when it comes to doing the siva, which I've always shied away from, and where possible got someone else to do that. I think I'm going to have to get some lessons, because mine is probably below average. But in general, pressure-wise, no, I just continue doing what I was doing, which is, doing my job to the best of my ability with the people at the heart of it who I set out to serve when I came into this role and every other role that I've been in. I feel in many ways empowered. This is not something that I have to show people on the daily, but knowing that it is there provides a level of strength that I didn't have previously. So I think it's going to hopefully, provide me with further confidence to do the work that I need to do.
Do you think people will look at you differently now that you have this, special marking, the malu?
Well, certainly so far, what I've experienced is a great sense of pride from all Samoans, not just Samoans, Pacific, across the board. They're very aware of what it represents. And so I think in many ways, the relationship between myself and the community is just further strengthened by having had this done. Also, what I've sensed already from social media and other places is a heightened sense of protection from the community, which is fitting, because the malu is about protection and shelter. And so I'm already feeling that from the community and from my family, and that is really comforting, actually.
Malu lover, Deputy Prime Minister, thank you, and we wish you all the best for the election.
Malu.